This lecture is mainly regarding definitions in basic cellular system. The basic definitions in cellular system is base station, mobile station, forward channel and reverse channel. Coming to the base station, it is a fixed station in a mobile radio system used for mainly radio communication with mobile stations. So base stations are located at the center, or they can be located at the on the edge of a coverage region, and it consists of mainly radio channels, transmitter and receiver antennas mounted on a tower. So coming to mobile station, it is a station in the cellular radio service intended for use while in motion at unspecified locations. So mobile stations may be handheld personal units called as portables, or installed in vehicles called as mobiles. So both of them comes under mobile station. Coming to the forward channel, it is a radio channel used for transmission of information from base station to mobiles, also called downlink channel. Coming to the reverse channel, it is a radio channel used for transmission of information from mobile to base station, and it is called as uplink channel. Generally, there will be confusion between these two channels. The transmission of information from base station to mobile is called as downlink channel, and the transmission of information from mobile to base station is called as reverse channel. So coming to the control channel, so radio channel used for transmission of call setup, that is setting up the call, initiation of the call, requesting the call and other control purposes, the control channel is used. And coming to handoff, it is a process of transferring a mobile station from one channel or one base station to another channel or another base station. So coming to next, MTSO, which is called as mobile telephone switching office. It is a switching center which coordinates the routing of calls in a large service area. In a cellular radio system, the mobile switching center connects the cellular base station and the mobiles to the public switch telephone network. So the mobile switching center is also called as mobile telephone switching office. And then next one is roamer. A mobile station which operates in a service area or market other than from which service has been subscribed and is entering to the other market, the other subscription region, they are called as a roamers. Coming to the subscriber, a user who pays subscription charges for using a mobile communication system is called as a subscriber. And coming to the simplex systems, it provide only one-way communication system. It may be half duplex system or full duplex system, two-way communication and one-way communication. Next, coming to the transceiver, it is a device capable of simultaneously transmitting and receiving radio signals. So next, coming to the basic cellular system, we are having mainly two basic cellular system, that is circuit switched system and packet switched system. Coming to the circuit switched system, it is a system in which each traffic channel is dedicated to a user. Whether the user is using or not, the channel is wasted until the call is the cell is terminated. That is called a circuit switched system. Next, coming to the packet switched system. In packet switching, the packets are sent towards the destination irrespective of each other. Each packet has to find its own route to the destination. There is no predetermined path. The decision as to which node to hop to in the next step is taken only when a node is reached. Each packet finds its way using the information it carries, such as the source and destination IP addresses. So here the main thing is each packet finds its way using the information the packet carries, such as source information and destination IP address. So next, coming to the circuit switching system, it is further divided into analog system, it is analog switched system and digital switched system. So in the next lecture, we will discuss about deeply architecture wise what is the components, elements the each system consists of. It is analog system and digital system, and analog circuit switched system. And under circuit switched system, we will discuss about analog circuit switched system and digital circuit switched system, and the packet switched system is separately we will discuss.